Hey guys, today we are flipping some bookshelves around, and that means I'm finally going to style my Harry Potter shelves. So, the shelf that I had in our other place, and it's a very tall one, and right now it is just kind of styled. There's one shelf that I actually like, it has all my books on it, but the rest of it is kind of just like mumble jumble. So I want to show you guys what it looks like right now, and we're going to bring in a brown shelf. It's shorter, it's not like the best shelf. Yes, I'd like white or something lighter. So here is the corner of the room. It's getting a little bit dark, but yeah, it's a big shelf. It's more traditional, as you can see the style over there. So the other bookshelf is going to go to about here, and I can hang this cork board that I have up there. I used to have wands on it, but all of my wands are currently back there. So I'm gonna style it, and it's going to be quite nice. Here's my assistant. So here is the office. This desk was over there along that wall, and we had the bookshelf here with all these cute things. So this is going to go because the bookshelf is taller. And those are all of his things that were on the bookshelf. So we're just gonna start moving it now. Here it is before it's all styled. It looks so cute in this corner. Hey guys, it's around 5:30 and I haven't vlogged all day. I've just been organizing the shelf, organizing underneath the bed a little bit, and also under my desk so there's not too much clutter around because I just don't want a lot of clutter. And I am so happy with how this shelf turned out. There is like a lot of clutter, and I took all my pops out, and I'm not used to seeing my stuff like out because it has been out for like 3 months since we've been here. And now I have my cork board set up, but everything isn't on it. There's just a few things on there. So I'm gonna flip you guys around and show you what it looks like and share how I display stuff. So up above we have the cork board. I just have some of the Beast pins and pins that I've gotten from subscription boxes. I have my little flags. I got those last fall when I went to the Wizarding World, and I did a haul, but I didn't upload it. So I got those, and I also got Ron's little outfit for the Yule Ball because it's so cute. And then I have my little Hogwarts purse, and there is stuff in there that I don't want out. And this actually is a Halloween decoration, this candle holder, but I just keep it out all year round because it's very witchy. And I have these LED lights that have a little remote control. I don't use them too often, but I put four in there just in case. This diamond shelf is from Michaels. I've had it for a couple years. It's gone through some different paint jobs, but it's white now. So I just have some little trinkets, little owl and this little locket, the Deathly Hallows locket. I have some stones, this unicorn that I refuse to get rid of. She actually has no like front paw there, but or hoof, but she's so beautiful. And then I have my little Niffler. He's an ornament, but I just kept him out all year round. And then I did string up these lights. I don't know if I'm keeping them because I don't know if I'll actually use them. Now for the first shelf, I have all my wands in the back, and then I have three pops. This is another thing that I got at the Wizarding World last year. It's this porcelain chocolate frog, but Levi knocked it over, so that's why it's cracked, and I have stuff in there. I actually got this card my first time at the Wizarding World years ago, so I just have some like other chocolate frog things and little pins inside. This back here is an incense burner. And then here I have Luna with a little crystal, her glasses, and a Pygmy Puff on top of book five. I just thought it looked really nice together, the pink and blue. Down here, this is my favorite shelf. So I have Ron's sweater, and I got that last time I went to the Wizarding World. I have worn it once. It's very itchy, but I had to have it, so it's a little complicated. I can only wear it with a turtleneck. I only have one turtleneck. And honestly, you can't wear it with a coat because it's kind of bulky. I have Ron's wand out here because I thought it would look cool. I have my Hufflepuff headband, this little patch. I still haven't put on anything. It's from The Cursed Child, and then a Harry Potter book back there.
And then I have Hagrid with my VHS of the Sorcerer's Stone and Norbert. And then over there I have the two other books that I have. I don't have a full set. I know I might be like committing some kind of Harry Potter crime because I don't have all the books, but it's fine, I'll get them eventually, because when I do get them, I want to get this set in particular. So I have Dumbledore and Snape. I don't have his wand. It got lost in some type of way, I don't know. And then this cup with some Nifflers and jewelry. And then down here, we have a little Fantastic Beasts section. So over there are three Hogwarts books, the public library books, and then a crystal. I have Dumbledore, Zowu, and two of the screenplays, Picket, and I have this cloche. I didn't know what to put in it, so I just put incense and this crystal. It all looked cool. And then I have this Marauder's Map, like, to-go mug, but I just have, like, these random wands in there. It's like a, I don't know, like, knockoff of wands, so they're not all the right color, but I have a bunch of them, so it's heavy, so I just put it in there. I have this little candle thing. It looks like a cauldron, so I like it. I've had it forever. I do have the Goblet of Fire, the illustrated version, so I like to display that because it's beautiful. And then this Hogwarts Express little snow globe. And then the bottom shelf is quite boring. I just have the Cursed Child and this mug that I got at the exhibit. I washed it a lot of times, so it's kind of destroyed, so it just stays there with more incense. And then inside of here are washcloths. I used to use this for my purse, but I retired it and gave it a break. So there are washcloths, one for every house. I got those so long ago that I don't know if they sell them anymore, but I'm so happy I have them. And then I have this Bath & Body Works candle that I customized and cut out the badger because I love it. Back there I have this chocolate frog artwork, and I don't know why it's there, honestly. And then I have a stack of books facing the wrong way because I don't like to see too much of the color or the binding. I don't know what it's called. So this is an overview of my shelf. It's very colorful, and I do like how the colors pop against the dark background. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little transformation of my Harry Potter shelf. I don't have all my Harry Potter stuff in one area. It is sprinkled throughout the house, so this is just stuff that I feel like can't really go anywhere else, like as far as regular decor. I have things that look more low-key, I should say, out there, but still not too much. So that's basically it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little short vlog and seeing how I display stuff. I definitely like to like stagger books, as you saw, to put pops so they're not all just at the same level, and make little like showcases, I suppose. So thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. I hope you're having a magical day. Bye.